This is Biblical Insights with Dr. Jim Denison of the Denison Forum, answering today's toughest questions.
When I'm attacked for being a Christian, how should I respond?
Well, we're in the place above all places to have that conversation. We're at this area called Mount Carmel. What you see around you is the Valley of Megiddo or Har Megiddo, sometimes called Armageddon. We think of that in the book of Revelation. We'll talk about that here before long. Just down below us is a spring of water, which is really important to an event that happened right in this area in 853 BC. So you've got the worship of Baal that is sweeping over the nation. It's a horrible, idolatrous kind of pagan religion, but it's become very common and popular. And if this continues, then God is going to have to judge the nation in the future of the nations in question. So God raises up this prophet called Elijah. And at this spot right here, he calls the prophets of Baal together. There's 450 prophets of Baal, 400 of Asherah, and they're all gathered there together. And it's in this very area that Elijah sets up a sacrifice that's described in 1 Kings 18. They place the bull on the altar and they pray to Elijah to send lightning, and nothing happens. Elijah places the bull on the altar, douses it with water, calls on God to send lightning, and God does. And in response, the people say, "The Lord, He is God. The Lord, He is God." It's Elijah against 850 prophets. If God doesn't send lightning in that moment, Elijah's future, of course, is in doubt. The future of the nation is very much in doubt as well. It's the courage of Elijah in that moment that was literally used by God as a tipping point to save the nation. The whole story could have ended in 1 Kings 18 if it were not for the courage of that one man. So from him, we learn this principle. If God is our king, we must trust him whether we want to or not, whether it's popular to or not, whether it's easy or not. We know he's king by the degree to which we obey him, whether we want to or not, when we pay a price, when we are willing to make a sacrifice to serve Jesus. So when we face adversity, when we face persecution, that's the decision to make. Who comes first, Jesus or me? Am I willing to pay a price to follow Jesus no matter the cost, knowing the cost that he paid on my behalf for me? Christians are being more persecuted than any other religion on earth. More Christians, 90% of all those that are facing religious persecution today are Christians. It's a question we're asking even in America, as more people are becoming opposed to the worldview that Christianity espouses and to Christian morality. So the question to ask ourselves when we face persecution today is, do I love Jesus enough to pay a price for him, remembering the price he paid for me? There's a story I would mention very quickly. Back at the turn of the 19th into the 20th century, William Borden was the heir of the Borden family fortune. He gave up that remarkable fortune to become a missionary to Muslims in China. On the way, he contracted meningitis and died before ever reaching his destination. After his death, inside his Bible was found the words, "No reserve, no retreat, no regrets." When that story was made public, thousands of people committed themselves to foreign mission work. And his story became part of a spiritual awakening. The opportunity for us today is to say no reserve, no retreat, no regrets, out of gratitude for the grace of God.
Thank you for watching Biblical Insights with Dr. Jim Denison of the Denison Forum. Follow us by clicking below for more answers to today's toughest questions.